Some of you may have objections with our key as usual, but we will have a fight at the end. We will have a zero hour. We will fully fight about what is your possible, because you are the ones who wrote the exam. I am like King Dhritarashtra. Vidura tells about this question is given, that question is given, and now I am talking about Mahabharata, right? So that's the point. What is the treatment of Meniere's disease? There is a medical management, surgical management available, but the surgical management is considered to be the mainstay of therapy, is what you have to basically remember. Especially so when the good number of patients become medically refractory, we do that. So what we do in the surgical management, we will be decompressing the hydrops of the endolymphatic sac, is considered to be the management of choice. Rising Star is one of our students who says V by Q mismatch is there, is that the possibility? See, anything can be possibility if the child did not improve clinically. Because the child is speaking well after taking salbutamol, I considered maybe false pulse oximetry placement in the earlier question. But anyway, we'll have a debate about that. Most common cause of the vocal cord palsy, it is basically a mass lesion. Tumor is the most common cause. Cleft lip, cleft palate. Without that, how will be a question paper of All India Institute will be? So, cleft palate is typically repaired between 9 to 12 months is the typical age. And lip is how much? How many months, doctor? Lip has 3 letters. So, 3 is the number you need to basically remember. Then, head injury patient is there, CSF leakage is there, but CT is not showing any fracture. CT, see, ECMO, the cribriform fracture is what you will look for. This is the normal cribriform, broken cribriform, but that is not shown. So, in all such scenarios, what will you do? You will wait for 5 to 6 days for spontaneous stoppage of leak. Okay? Generally, doctor, generally the rule is wait and watch if it is there in the 4 options. Examiner want you to choose that. There are at least some 40-50 surgical conditions where only wait and watch. There is no wait and watching in general medicine. In general medicine, most of the conditions, do something, talk and do. Surgery may wait and watch or completely be radical. So that's the reason, be sure, I mean, general rule of thumb. Malignant otitis externa is typically caused by Pseudomonas, and it can percolate into the base of the skull and infect, and it can be associated with otitis media. But it does not lead to any hearing loss. That's the point you need to appreciate. Oh, this is a beautiful question. If you are having a mobile phone and an internet, I think most of you maybe should be, must be having a smartphone. So nowadays, 150 rupees we get a internet package. So you go to newsformedico.com and you will have around 1600 topics, notes also we are putting it as a free article, individual article subject wise, you can browse anytime. And every day we keep posting new discussions and MCQs, so that's the idea. So you can go to that, there you click on AIMS discussion, you have all these notes available. You also have free download section available. In that also we will upload the PDF. So that way. Now doctor, cavernous sinus thrombosis. Beautiful question. See, in the cavernous sinus thrombosis, trigeminal has 3 divisions, ophthalmic, maxillary, mandibular. It is the mandibular division which is important for the jaw jerk. That is not involved in the cavernous sinus thrombosis. That's the reason jaw jerk is not affected. Because ophthalmic division is affected, there is a periorbital pain in the case of the cavernous sinus thrombosis. So the examiner's question was, it occurs commonly in ethmoid sinusitis. There is a true statement. There is a loss of periorbital sensation, which is also true, but there is no loss of jaw jerk reflex, is what you have to be very sure about. Now, doctor, any state MD entrance paper you go, doctor, previous last 10 years, rhinal alia aperta, rhinal alia closa. In 2001, when I took MD entrance 14 years back also, that was the same question. So, you have two kinds of speeches. What are they? Mukesh ke jaise naak se gaane wale, aur Bhupen Hazarika and Bhimsen Joshi, they use their full bass of the throat. Dekho dekho gabbar singh. Like that, they have got a, some people have got a very strong throat voice. Why? There is a difference. So, doctor, hypernasal speech is adenoid hypertrophy, allergic rhinitis or deviated septum. But if you remove the adenoid, it leads to development of hypernasality, is what you need to basically remember. Not the hyponasality, that is what the examiner has asked. And what are other complications? There can be a below pharyngeal insufficiency. So typically the uvula and its appropriation with the posterior pharyngeal wall at the time of our speech is very important for the protection of the speech. So below pharyngeal insufficiency is one of the complications. So what is the very high yield topic in entrance exam in the ENT? If you go through the list, tonsillectomy, adenoidectomy. Without that, there is no paper. Okay, doctor? Vocal cord laryngeal cancer is the most high yield topic in the top 20 list. If you didn't collect the, what are the 30 topics you need to read in all 19 subjects, totally 600-700 topics only you need to read. If you didn't collect, please collect the booklet with our guys so that you can focus your preparation. Even our Sunday mock test also, we orient more towards very high yield topics and try to check your performance. Now, doctor, post-operative steroids. Suppose if chronic rhinosinusitis is associated with a polyp, then there is a role for post-operative steroids. But if it is not associated with the polyps, then there is no role for the steroids. That's the point the examiner wants. And this is a straight repeat from the previous AIIMS November 2013 discussion we had on the same floor last year. It is available on the YouTube. Now, doctor, there is a small lytic lesion. Now starts the story of orthopedics. Some of you attended recently our orthopedics classes Monday to Friday. What is the most high yield topic? Definitely examiner will test bone tumors. Exam is not for 200 marks, but only 199, because one question definitely comes from bone tumors. Not one, sometimes 3-4 questions come from bone tumors. A pura orthopedics either se udhar padke bone tumors ko, if you could not get in control, then you have not read at all orthopedics. So doctor, what is your answer? Osteoid osteoma typically is a diaphyseal lesion, shaft of the tibia, he said. Only two lesions are diaphyseal, Ewing sarcoma among malignancies and osteoid osteoma among benign tumors. And additionally, what is there? There is a nidus with a sclerosing lesion. Sclerosing lesion with a nidus is a very classical feature which is found on the shaft, makes the answer to become osteoid osteoma is what you need to remember. Vaizag is saying anthracoinal polyp is the answer given in Amit and Asish. Even in anthracoinal polyps also, postoperatively to prevent recurrence, you will be using the steroid actually. I don't know. I mean, but that's a also a very good authoritative book followed by all students. We'll put some of our answers which can turn debatable towards the end. But please be ready with your specific objection round. Congenital telehepatosequinovirus is a very high yield topic, no? to understand that you must know what is subtalar joint, what happens in supination and pronation of the foot. So doctor, whenever we do pronation of the foot, then what happens? Subtalar joint is pronated actually, and it will be pronating on the axis of the calcaneocuboid joint, which is parallel to the axis of the talonavicular joint. These are the two joints whose axes are typically parallel to each other whenever the foot is subtalar joint is undergoing. What is subtalar joint? Tibio-talar. Talus and tibia. Talus ke niche kya hai? Calcaneum hai. Calcaneum ke aage kya hai? Cuboid and navicular hai. So talus forms a relation with calcaneum below, cuboid and also with navicular. So that's what you need to basically remember. Sun ray appearance is what? Why the sun rays are there? It is a type of periosteal reaction. I think a very simple question. So iske liye special preparation chahiye kya? Nahi chahiye. Ek baar padhe to most of the questions you can answer. And anyway, 60, 70, 45, 50 questions you are not in your hands. You have to only guesswork. I'll also show you where your luck fares better than what you have read. A 2-year-old unable to move the elbow and crying after the mother has lifted the baby. The uncooperative baby. Very high yield topic. Right? Pulled elbow. And it's very simple. You supinate the arm, forearm and flex it, and automatically it will reset. So annular ligamental tear is responsible for the pulled elbow is what you have to basically remember. Osteoporosis has happened. After 1 year, hemiparesis patient, what is the most common location for the osteoporosis? Yes, doctor. Let us ask our online students to punch their possible answers. You punch along with the question number, we like to see your answers, because we have nearly about 90 online viewers. This technology can accommodate around 1 million online viewers concurrently, like a football match broadcast. So we are very happy. So rising star, Mona, Srinivas, Balina, everyone says upper end of femur. Yes, the most common location. Hemiparetic individual, where you will find Collins fracture. Array, top 20 topics mein orthopedics agar kabhi bhi MBBS mein nahi padke phir bhi pass ho gaya to entrance ke liye padna hai to bahut dar lagega. Humko bhi bahut dar laga when we prepared. So that is the reason you must be very choosy. What are those 20 topics? First time I will understand where is radius. Radius is upper limb bone or lower limb bone. No problem. Even if you start at that level, if you stick to only 20 topics, you can finish orthopedics. But if you think that I will read orthopedics book and set the supracondylar fracture, going to hospital means impossible. Not for this entrance, next life entrance. So doctor, what is your answer? Ulnar tilt, dorsal tilt. There are two types of tilts. So typically if you take Smith's fracture, it is extra articular ulnar displaced. Collins fracture is opposite to that. After the fracture in the distal part of the radius ho gaya, then what will happen? There is a displacement dorsally. Then you call it as Collie. And then a ulnar means towards palm. Ventrally ho gaya, then that becomes the Smith's fracture is what you need to remember. Okay, doctor? Ha. Brechner and Bethune. What did they discover? If they ask who discovered nitrous oxide only, we are not sure. I say questions dekar. Negative marking bhi dekar. Negative marking hai kya? Aims mein? Our state entrance also is becoming the same. I say questions kyo dete? Aapko masala sambar mein చీంచిన కెలి. సో బీ ష్యూర్ టు నాట్ బి లూర్డ్ అండ్ డోంట్ బి ఈగర్ టు ఆన్సర్ ఈవెన్ దట్ ఆల్సో. నో, ఇట్స్ నాట్ ఫర్ యూ. సో ఎండ్ టైడల్ మానిటర్, కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ మానిటర్, దే డిడ్ ట్రెమెండస్ వర్క్ ఆన్ పల్మనరీ ఎంబాలిజం. హౌ టు ఐడెంటిఫై పల్మనరీ ఎంబాలిజం? ఇఫ్ దర్ ఇస్ అన్ ఎంబోలస్ ఇన్ ది వెసల్, ద కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ ఇన్ ద బ్లడ్ కెనాట్ జంప్ ఇన్ టు అల్వియోలస్ టు గో అవుట్. సో ఇఫ్ యూ చెక్ ఫర్ ది ఎండ్ టైడల్ కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ లెవెల్స్, ఇట్ విల్ బి ఫాలింగ్ డౌన్ ఇఫ్ దర్ ఇస్ ఎనీ ఎంబోలస్ ఇన్ ది పల్మనరీ సర్క్యులేషన్. దట్ ఈస్ ద పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ ఐడెంటిఫైయింగ్ పల్మనరీ ఎంబోలిజం యూజింగ్ ఎండ్ టైడల్ మానిటర్, బ్రెచర్ అండ్ బెతూన్. బట్ ఓన్లీ ఎయిమ్స్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఫేమస్ ఫర్ గివింగ్ వన్ నోబెల్ ఆర్ ఎయిట్ ఆర్ వన్ శ్రీవాస్తవ కమిటీ ఆర్ సంథింగ్, బట్ దిస్ టైమ్ నో కమిటీస్ హ్యావ్ కమ్. రైట్. పేషెంట్ హ్యాడ్ ఐ సర్జరీ, ప్రోపోఫాల్ సర్జనైల్ కొలిన్ వాస్ గివెన్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఐ సర్జరీ ఆర్ బాడీ పెయిన్స్ కే బీచ్ మే కుచ్ బి నహీ హై, ఇట్స్ ఓన్లీ లూరింగ్ యూ. బిట్వీన్ సర్జనైల్ కొలిన్ ప్రోపోఫాల్, వాట్ ఈస్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ది పోస్ట్ ఆపరేటివ్ మజిల్ పెయిన్స్? Sarginyl choline is the one responsible. When you give sarginyl choline, there will be initially some fasciculations which happen. Because of those fasciculations, there is a lot of body ache which will basically develop. Sarginyl choline. Anesthesia kya hai only? One local anesthetic, one general anesthetic, one muscle relaxant, one ventilator settings if you are still breathing. And one, leave it to God, some scientist. Finish, 5 questions are over. And more than Monday, you should not read anesthesia. That's a rule. Sarginyl choline is what you need to basically remember. Which IV drug you want to use for daycare surgery? If you don't do the answer to this, please come. We will give free coaching. Minimum question this is. What is propofol called? Milk of amnesia is the one which you basically use it. Where will you place levine shunt? Ek baar levine shunt kya hai malum hai to, you can, cirrhosis of liver, portal hypertension management is one of the favorite questions of the examiner. So doctor, peritoneal venous shunt is called levine, which drains the peritoneal fluid from the peritoneum into the veins is what you need to basically remember. That's the reason it is connected between peritoneum and superior vena cava. Directly you will be connecting the levine shunt. Okay doc. Where do you see weeping umbilicus? After birth actually umbilicus ke upar thoda granulation tissue is not uncommon, because you are cutting the umbilical cord. But if it is persisting, you should always suspect a patent vitello intestinal duct. So that is the reason patent uracus is responsible for the weeping umbilicus is what you have to basically remember. So tell me, first surgery may first two questions easy to achieve. Now let us see. I told you, now what is our criteria to be in the first 100 ranks in any entrance exam? Surgery may, gynops may, 30 out of 30 ana, 100% marks ana, because there is nothing to guess in them. 50-year-old became giddy and he passed fresh blood in his stools. Previous examination for carcinoma colon screening was normal. What is the likely cause? Diverticulosis. You agree with me? The recent, last Sunday also we had a MCQ. What are the main cause for this? Exsanguinating perirectal bleeding in case of elderly person. Diverticulosis is what you have to basically expect in this given scenario. 10-year-old girl has alopecia, mental retardation, and there is a crepitus felt. So what is that you have, doctor? Easy question. Trichobezar. Pura surgery text mein alopecia kaha aayega? If at all it comes only in trichobezar. Hai na? Are there any intestinal tumors associated with alopecia? No. That's important. There are intestinal tumors associated with osteomas, Gardner syndrome, wo sab hai. So if you know what chapters are there in surgery textbook also, you can crack 30 out of 30 in surgery. What chapters are there in surgery? Ek bar पूरे टेक्स्ट बुक को फैन के नीचे लगा के पूरा पेजेस एक बार टक 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 टर्न करो। वाई फैन के नीचे? अगर इफ यू आर वेरी स्लो इन रीडिंग एटलीस्ट फैन विल मूव सम पेजेस, दैट्स द रीजन। नाउ दिस लास्ट 3 months, 4 months, you have to brisk doctor. You should not get sticky about any topic. You have to put alarm, stopwatch. 25-30 minutes khatam. 10 points, 12 points, like that you should read. You should not read like a serious academic student. You should not be. That's the idea. What is least pre-malignant? Actually speaking, the hematomas of cute jagger are also malignant, pre-malignant. Generally, hematomas are not pre-malignant, but hematomas of Peutz Jeghers are pre-malignant. But out of all the four given, least would be Peutz Jeghers ka pre-malignant. Last week, Sunday also, we had a MCQ based on the same. So, what is the most high-yielding topic? Carcinoma colon, definitely one question will come on adenomas, etc., etc. Thyroid. Top 20 topics may in surgery, you have thyroid. FNAC of thyroid cannot distinguish follicular adenoma and carcinoma because carcinoma will show capsular invasion, which can be identified only if you do biopsy, not by fine needle aspiration, is what you need to remember. There is a bilious vomiting in the case of a neonate. Very good. Kapil is proposing ultrasound for question number 31. Kapil's answer is ultrasound. What is your answer? Simple thing is, baby gram means abdominal x-ray of the baby's abdomen is called as baby gram. Right? If you do baby gram, it will let you know fluid levels, lot of truths about what is the cause of the obstruction. So that is the reason baby gram would be the best investigation, and the first investigation is what you need to basically appreciate. So bilious vomiting, retained meconium and abdominal distension are the three classical features which are the clinical triads to say that small intestinal obstruction is there, is what you need to basically remember. So what is the main investigation? Plain x-ray abdomen, KUB or baby gram is the first important investigation that you need to basically do. Now doctor, a baby cries, holds the knee closer to abdomen, maroon colored bleed is there, still you are unable to identify intussusception in that, you are too late for the state MD entrance. Okay, intussusception is the favorite high yield topic for the examiner. What are the most common sign of myeloma? What is your stomach is the classical location is what you need to remember. Orphan amyoid cells containing radiograph, histopathological slide was given. You are all waiting now what kind of picture based questions will come in state MD entrance. Simple questions will be there. They will show you India map and ask you where is Andhra Pradesh, Telangana. Simple map pointing will be there. Don't be crowded and clouded about what they are going to ask. If it is too complex image, 95% students don't understand. So there is a reason it will be a simple orphan aneoid. Orphan aneoid, where is it located, doctor? Papillary carcinoma is what you need to basically remember. Baby did not pass the stool in 48 hours. Abdominal distension is there. There are two possibilities. One is Hirschsprung, other is meconium ileus. So meconium ileus, how will you identify is the question. I am not sure about the options. Are there any? Manometry was also there. But manometry anyway will not help you. Lower GI contrast study is also there. Okay. I think I did not get full clues. I told you, I am a blind king, Dhritarashtra. You have to tell me what were given in the options. So, I leave this for reframing the question. Okay. 3000 molecular weight similar to albumin. The only other colloid that we commonly use clinically is dextran. Is the one which you need to remember. A girl with swelling on the posterior aspect of the thigh. there are no arterial components in that malformation, only it is a pure venous malformation is what the examiner specifically told. How are you going to occlude? Basically, we use three types of embolizing agents. Sclerosing agents is one type, right? Then we use adhesive particles to embolize a vascular malformation. Everything has a merits, demerits. I leave the literature for you. So out of all, we can't use polyvinyl alcohol classically in this given scenario, which is purely venous without any arterial component, is what need to be basically remembered. Okay, so I leave the literature for you. On your mobile phone it will be available, you can review that. Now I'm not sure whether they have given photosensitivity rash, which is malar rash of SLE, or some people say acne rosacea was given. Rosacea? But how will you explain psychological manifestations for that? Yeah? Huh? Telangiectasia is also there. That will be there in both. That won't be there in SLE, you want to say. Okay, this I am not very sure, must be between the two depending upon what was the actual illustration. Alright. Tense blisters along with pruritus, elderly man, finish, only three clues. Flaccid bulle, tense bulle. What in dermatology also only 20 topics you should read for exam. One of them is pemphigus vulgaris, bullous pemphigoid and dermatitis herpetiformis. Jarur aane wale topics hai. So elderly man may tense bulle, which is extremely pruritic, is a very important clue. Being itchy is the nature of bullous pemphigoid classically. Another thing remember, young individual hai pemphigus vulgaris hone ke chances jyada rehte, elderly person hai chances of bullous pemphigoid are higher. Paraneoplastic manifestation will be which one between the two? Bullous pemphigoid is more likely to be a paraneoplastic manifestation. Neoplasias occur in elderly or young people? Elderly. That also will fit with the description. Okay, doctor. So this is what you need to basically remember. Pradeep is saying, please email me the PDF notes. Absolutely, we will keep a download available in the newsformedico.com. You can simply go register your email ID and one password for yourself. And you can go to the download section and click and download. We will put all our notes, ENT, ophthal, SPM, orthopedics, all general medicine, every notes PDF will be made available. You can click and download. Okay, so that is a option in newsformedico.com. You can also participate in discussion forums are also available, but we will not be that controversial gossip mongering forums. We have a lot of content available. So you can write articles, good MCQs and publish it as a web page. That will be a better contribution. Now doctor, what is not an abdominal method of sterilization? Definitely SPM bulletin, top 20 topics may you have tubectomy, vasectomy, OCP, contraception. High yield topic, highest yield topic. Essur. What is Essur? Through fallopian tube, you will be placing it in the fallopian tube. This device that will lead to scar formation, adhesions, and block the tube and prevent the Mr. Sperm and Miss Egg from meeting each other. That's what it will be doing. So it is done through fallopian tube. You don't do abdominally. Then avian influenza, H5N1, why will it not cause pandemic? So it causes high fatality. Because by breathing into your friend's nose, it won't transmit. And you will die before breathing into your friend's nose. It is so highly fatal. So main reason is human to human transmission is not there. That makes it to not go pandemically is what need to be basically remembered. So what are epigenetic studies basically? very simple, doctor. If your dad is cardiologist, mom is neurologist, at least you are supposed to become hospital administrator. MBBS, Master of Hospital Administration. But after 10th pass hone ke liye bhi bahut mushkil ho rahe. Then we will do a genetic analysis. Genes wahan se aa rahe, magar isko aisa phenotype kyun ho gaya? Then you get a report that no, genes are correct only. It is not, it is the correct baby born only. But from childhood he was fed with so much money, comforts, Mercedes, Benz, Porsche, every car. So he has no drive for reading. So same genotype will produce different phenotype. That is called epigenetic modification. So how will you study that? HPLC, methylation, bisulfite sequencing, all these are the methods which are used for doing that. But not chip on chip. Once more, what is chip on chip? It is a technology which will combine chromatin immunoprecipitation with the DNA microarray, and it is basically to done for a different purpose. I leave the literature for you to review. Okay. Once more, this is outlier, complete bouncer for any student. If you are able to answer this also, you have given a party to the examiner. Unless otherwise, it's very difficult. Is it the same question? Because ICDS may, what will you give to the pregnant women was given. All the literature says 600 calories in 18 grams, no? A 380, 330, options are same only. You have any say to talk about it? Huh? Okay, 300 or 330. What shall be the then answer? Why 330? Is there any recommendation saying like that? It is 618 grams actually. I don't know what was there in the examiner mind, or maybe not only our mock tests, even actual exam papers also can have few printing mistakes. What is not associated with vaccine derived polio? Is this question is in your hands or examiner hand? Examiner hand. Pehle baar malum padega. Itna sub varieties hai vaccine associated polio virus mein bolke. तो उसमें C है, A है, I है, मगर M नहीं है. अगर M नहीं है बोल के आपको सडन पूर्व जन्म सुकृत से नॉलेज आ गया एग्जाम में, यू आर लकी. एंड डोंट वरी इफ यू डिड दिस रॉन्ग. हार्ट फेल्यूर मार्कर, दिस इज अ वेरी कॉमन एमसीक्यू इन द एम्स क्वेश्चन बैंक. लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स इट वाज आस्क्ड. देयर आर सम रीनल मार्कर्स, देयर आर सम सीरम मार्कर्स. सो व्हाट इज योर आंसर डॉक्टर? You like to say? Septuin, septuin, whatever you like to call. Yes, that is not a marker. Whereas B type, natriuretic peptide, troponins, they are all considered to be. Whereas septuin, what is their main purpose? I leave the literature for you to review. Artesunate is what we use for malaria falciparum. In this India, with 3 months of paid holiday to rural villages, if you still could not answer this artesunate question, that will be very bad. Huh? Now, this is our favorite question in the entire world. Hundreds of times we discussed valvular heart disease. Mitral stenosis hai to left atrial ka blood left ventricle ke andar jana hi mana hai. Agar wo nahi jana hai to left ventricle has no work at all. Why will it fail? It won't fail. Failure of the left ventricle is called, failure of the left ventricle lead to third heart zone. Non-compliance of the left ventricle, diastolic failure will lead to fourth heart zone. Third heart zone lead due to systolic failure. Systolic failure will never occur if it is a pure mitral stenosis. When will systolic failure in S3 will be heard in mitral stenosis? If the mitral stenosis is associated with MR or mitral stenosis is associated with AR, then only left ventricular dilatation and failure will occur. Then S3 will appear. S3 doesn't appear if it is a pure mitral stenosis is what you need to basically remember. Okay. Yeah. Option D was option D was loud first hand sound. Right. Vizag has rightly corrected. So we thank our Vizag, Tirupati, and so many students who have sent all the recalled MCQs on the WhatsApp and Facebook. And nowadays things are more easy. Actually, I thought all of you will be from home watching, and I am happy that you all came to the class. Triad of clinical features: angina, syncope, dyspnea, which is exertional. What is your answer? Yes, aortic stenosis. The small correction, typographic mistake. Aortic stenosis, you have all the three features. Tension pneumothorax, suddenly patient has been hit by a bull and brought to you, doctor. What will you do as a house surgeon? You will take a needle and place it into the second intercostal space at the midclavicular level in order to first give a proper ventilation of the lung. Meningitis in the, I have given 25 topics in neurology to read for general medicine. Last week we discussed Saturday, Sunday in our medicine class. Meningitis is one of the 6th or 7th high yielding topic. Without that, there is no paper. So, cefotaxime, were there any different options? Same. Taxime was there? Those who took the exam. No, you don't recall. Any other competing option? Any third generation cephalosporin mainly. Empirical management of meningitis. Which one you will not see in elderly but in children, pediatric population may? Kawasaki. Kawasaki lead to coronary vasculitis. Child gets a heart attack. That becomes the Kawasaki disease. One question on vasculitis. Without that, there is no paper. Polyarteritis nodosa, Bergner, Churg-Strauss, Takayasu, Kawasaki. 100% you should be sure, doctor. More than 90% association of HLA B27. Where do you have, doctor? What is your answer? Typically in ankylosing spondylitis, 90 to 95%. Reactive arthritis, 60 to 90%, and 50 to 60% in psoriatic arthritis. Very easy question. Really not tough. Tuberous sclerosis may white matter lesions hoga, subependymal tumors hoga, giant cell astrocytoma hoga, magar ependymoma nahi hoga. Right? So what is your answer? Ependymoma should be the answer. One neurocutaneous syndrome is a very common MCQ. Neurofibromatosis type 2, what is the type of chromosome? Something or other examiner will ask. Adenoma, sebaceum, etc., etc. Now doctor, first neurological disorder due to single neurotransmitter deficiency is which one? You like to say? Parkinsonism. What is your answer? What is the rule, doctor? If Alzheimer is there in the options, what should be the answer? Alzheimer should be the answer. Because one question supposed to come on Alzheimer. What neurotransmitter is deficient in Alzheimer? Acetylcholine deficiency. Hence we treat it by giving tacrin is what you need to basically remember. But still, if you take Parkinsonism, it is acetylcholine and also dopamine ke beech mein. Similarly, Huntington chorea is also all the three types, dopamine, acetylcholine, anything imbalance will lead to development of Huntington's. So that is a, probably that is there in the mind of the examiner. If gout is in the four options in rheumatology, what is the answer? Gout. You know high yield topics you will pass exam, right? Everything about gout treatment, everything you should read, doctor. Shortly you will be going to PGH Chandigarh. One question on gout definitely aayega, jarur aayega. This is a useless, unexpected pregnancy. Non-specific, it is not just unexpected pregnancy, post-menopausal unexpected pregnancy. Non-specific interstitial pneumonia. ILD is one topic, doctor. Pulmonology may, after reading, if you still survive, tell me. If you don't have nystagmus, confabulation, diplopia, intranuclear ophthalmoplegia, all will develop. ILD is one topic, boring topic in pulmonology, but still you have to read for entrance. See doctor, non-specific interstitial pneumonia is one form of idiopathic interstitial pneumonia. What is the difference between the two? Idiopathic interstitial pneumonia mein jara ye achha wala variety hai. Nagpur Santra, right? It will be little better. Good prognosis will be there. No honeycombing. Honeycombing is the nature of all ILDs. That is not the nature of non-specific interstitial pneumonia. That is what examiner want to ask. So if he ask this, what is he going to ask in All India entrance? BOOP. BOOP is what obliterative bronchitis obliterans with organizing pneumonia is going to be a question which is waiting for you in the next exam. Take it. When is the PGA entrance? Huh? Next Sunday? Are every Tuesday we will have some other, you will also have a cup of tea, don't worry. We will also treat you with a good cup of tea. Without you people, our life has no meaning and no purpose. So I am very happy you all came, and online we have about 102 is the number online. Very happy. Now doctor, non-pulmonary causes and their matching diagnosis. All visas are not asthma is a very important rule. Even pulmonary edema of the congestive heart failure also lead to development of bronchoconstriction and wheezing. Similarly, when acidosis is there, high respiratory rate will be there. And pericarditis will lead to chest pain. How will you differentiate that from angina? If you lean forward, there is a relief of pain if it is pericarditis pain. So that is what you need to remember. Sinosis and anxiety are not related. Okay? So, H reflex, this is another about the brain question. They are prepared for what is tibialis anterior reflex, what is S1, where is active jerk, root values. Our exam ko gaye. Examiner suddenly H reflex kaha hota hai means it is purely laboratory based question. So what is your answer doctor? S1 radiculopathy mein you will look at the conduction velocities of the nerves and some latencies will be created which are called H reflex, which is used in lumbosacral radiculopathy, specifically S1 radiculopathy is the answer is what need to be remembered. Right. What is least commonly involved in rheumatic heart disease, doctor? Pulmonary or TS? PS, sir? PS or TS? I didn't get time to check that. We'll recheck this. We'll recheck this. Actually, tricuspid stenosis occurred in only 3% of the cases. They have done necropsy of about 1010 cases. They found only 3%. 3% say they come here, PS. We'll check that. Right. One lobe of the brain dysfunction, definitely one question will come. High yield topic, lobar dysfunction. Attention, concentration are there in which lobe, doctor? Parietal or frontal? Parietal or frontal? Attention may different types of attention are there. Actually, frontal, parietal, both are important. But inattention, half of the body, they have inattention, visual inattention. In which lobar dysfunction you get? Parietal lobe. That's the reason answer becomes parietal is what you need to basically remember. Now doctor, match the immunohistochemical marker. One tumor marker definitely they ask, what is your answer? Sarcomas are Vimentin, lymphomas are CLA, melanomas are S100. Generally desmin is a marker of mesenchymal and muscle tissue. That's the reason it's more for sarcomas rather than carcinomas is what we need to remember. Without apoptosis, kabhi paper ho takya? Nahi hoga. బ్యాక్స్ జీన్, బ్యాడ్ జీన్, ప్రో ఎపటోటిక్, యాంటీ ఎపటోటిక్, డెఫినెట్లీ వన్ పాయింట్ వన్ క్వశ్చన్ విల్ కమ్. క్యాష్ స్పేసెస్, ఎవ్రీథింగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రీడ్ అండ్ గో. పెథాలజీ ఫైవ్ మార్క్స్ ఇన్ పెథాలజీ అండ్ సపోజ్ వన్ కంపల్సరీ ఈజ్ ఎపటోసిస్ ఆర్ నెక్రోసిస్, యూ హ్యావ్ టు రివ్యూ. యాక్చువల్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద గ్లూకోకార్టికాయిడ్స్ విచ్ విల్ ఇండ్యూస్ ది ఎపటోసిస్. దట్ ఆన్సర్ బికమ్ గ్లూకోకార్టికాయిడ్స్. 5 deletion was given as a karyotype and that should obviously be Cridchat. One question on gastrointestinal stromal tumors is a very high yield topic. Basically it originates from the interstitial cells of Kajal, which is true. Prognosis depends on the size, which is also true. But ALK mutations are not associated. What mutations are associated? C-KIT mutations are associated. Now comes the question, where are the ALK mutations associated, doctor? Large cell lymphomas, you are having the ALK mutations basically. And also, I leave the literature for you. You can review, where do you find the other ones? Cancer is associated with what important changes? Is it the question or most common change associated with the cancer was the question? Most common was there, All except kind of question, no? Except was not there is what some people are saying. But anyway, point is, hypomethylation of oncogenes or hypermethylation of tumor suppressor genes, which will lead to silencing of this. Whenever methylation occurs, there is a silencing of the suppressor. So that leads to tumor. So first two are correct. Loss of heterozygosity is also a pro-oncogenic thing. I think D should be the answer. Okay? I'm not sure whether most common was asked or what was asked. I leave that for benefit of doubt. Gray white mass in the central bronchus. What are the two tumors which are central located, doctor? SSC. Squamous and small are central. Adeno is basically peripheral. Gray white mass on grass appearance is often a feature of squamous cell carcinoma. Squamous cell carcinoma is associated with elongated spindle arrangement. That brings the answer to option D, is what you need to basically remember. Schwannoma, what do you have? Antony A, Antony B. Very commonly asked question. Previous question wala database may routinely asked question. Variform stomiform pattern. One of the options which was given. It is important in fibrous histiocytoma may you find the stomiform pattern. Asbestosis exposure is there, upper lung mass is there. What that mass should be? Mesothelioma. What is the classical characteristic histopathological feature of the mesothelioma is a very important question. Microvilli, long microvilli, detection of that is considered to be the classical feature. Oh, this is a beautiful question. Antigen is free, antibody is free, both of them met in the Indira Park and married in RSMH. They went and deposited somewhere. What do you call it as? Type 3. Type 3 is immune complex mediated. Antigen is fixed. She is the princess in the fort of the king. Antibody went like a prince to hijack her and attacked it. So what is that called? Where antibody goes and attacks a fixed tissue, you call? Type 2. A hemolysis mediated by penicillin allergy may kya hota? Anti-penicillin antibodies are developed. And they will go and hit the RBC antigen, which is fixed on the surface of the RBC. Hence it comes under type 2, antibody mediated hypersensitivity. So type 2 should be the answer. Okay? Now, let's go to the next question. this is another outlier. If you try to guess, you lose 1/4 of your limb. So don't do that. Fir bhi aapka fortune ko try karo. Those who didn't take AIIMS exam. Tax, sir. Pit, sir. Pit X3 is seen in the posterior polar congenital cataract. Now you know when to guess, when to not guess. It is as good as deciding whom to propose and whom to not propose. If you don't guess, what you need to do? You need to propose to all girls in the class and ultimately get accepted by one among them by probability theory. Pitex, tax, there is utna farak hai. Be very sure. This is another beyond Vedantic question in ophthalmology. Iron foreign body in the retina, how will you identify? Iron foreign body in the retina. Siderosis bulbi, it is called as. It is an electroretinogram which can detect and prognosticate the sclerotic changes whenever there are intraocular foreign bodies like iron antibody is what need to be remembered. This is a very, very commonly asked MCQ. Previous old question bank. Laser trabeculoplasty, where will you do? You have a variety called pseudo exfoliation syndrome. What is this glaucoma? What is the specialty of it? All of you received T? Anybody did not, please raise hand. T guy will be leaving. One more round T ke liye aane ke liye bolna. Kyunki we have to finish all questions, right? Are we going too slow? We will go fast because some of you didn't take exam. Right, doctor. Pseudo exfoliation may, there is a fibrillar proteinaceous material which will be accumulating at the canal of Schlemm. That's the reason you need to basically repair it by doing laser trabeculoplasty is what you have to basically remember. Oh, this is another Vedantic question in ophthalmology, doctor. Light peak to dark trough ratio in EOG. Does the examiner doesn't know that we passed it in ophthalmology by reading only two topics? Cataract and glaucoma. Too much, no? Ye pura retina wala, wo bhi EOG, ERG, pehle baar ab hum sun rahe terms ko. So, what is that ratio? Typically, it is also called as Arden's ratio, basically. And if it is 1.8 and greater, then it is normal. 1.65 to 1.8 subnormal, less than 1.65 it is considered to be significantly subnormal. And what is that ratio is basically because for what it is it used, I leave the literature for you. Now comes pharmacology. Opening question in pharmacology, doctor. Pseudomembranous colitis and vancomycin. If you could not answer this, your general condition is very poor, poorly nourished. Then ये क्वेश्चन के लिए थोड़ा पढ़ना है एमबीबीएस फार्माकोलॉजी डेज में विच जनरेशन केफलोस्पोरिन इज अ वेरी डर्टी क्लासिफिकेशन एवरीथिंग लुक्स सब 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 बट आयाक्सोन ईएक्सोन ओआक्सोन सो विल बी ऑक्सीमोरोन सो एंटी एमआरएसए ओनली फिफ्थ जनरेशन केफलोस्पोरिन हैव एंटी एमआरएसए एक्शन Oh, it is given as which third generation was also given? None of the fifth generation were given. Okay, then ceftriaxone has got. Is it not ceftriaxone? Ferrazone was also there. That we will check and come back. Yeah. But anyway, doctor, I did not get information that only third generation was asked. We will check the correct answer. But remember, Lane. Four important organisms against which cephalosporins generally don't have activity. Listeria and atypicals, mycoplasma and chlamydia and MRSA and enterococci. Lyme against which cephalosporins don't have action is what you need to basically remember. Yeah. That's right. Third generation, we will search which one has a... Generally, fifth generation have got a MRSA action.